And welcome back to another BobBlast. Hi, I'm Bob Burridge, and this one is a little extra special. It's all about what I take when I do plein air painting or on-location painting. You know, and I don't want to bring a whole lot of stuff because it goes in the luggage, and you all know about that. So I'm going to show you the simple things that I take with me when I go to do my painting on location. So over the past 20 years, I've done a lot of on-location workshops. And boy, have I ever learned not to take too much. You know, we're all enthusiastic. We think we need our entire studio. Well, no, you don't. Besides, it adds weight to your luggage. So, but here's my setup. It's pretty simple. This is one of those Easel, very nice lightweight Easel. I can carry a lot of paint inside here. I have a nice backboard. I can put paper on it, which is really nice. And the paper actually gets mounted on Gator Board or foam board. And that just sits right up in here and the paper gets taped right to it. So it's a nice, it's also a nice lap board for those of you who don't want to take an easel. Just sit down in a nice comfortable chair and sit there and sketch there and have a great time watching the sunsets and doing your paintings too. All right, so that's pretty important stuff right there. Keeps everything nice and steady. Now the papers that I use, of course you've known me now for a while, and I'm using the Kilimanjaro Watercolor Paper. Comes in a spiral, nice to be able to tear it out like that, right? And it's great, it takes all kinds of watercolors and acrylics. And I like the fact that it's spiral bound so I can fold it back on itself. And also, this is the Kilimanjaro Watercolor Paper, and this is the American Journey, the Chief Joe American Journey, and it's very conveniently put in a spiral bound, and it's heavy duty, it's 300 pound paper. So I think you might wanna like that 300 pound paper. But you can see whether it's 140 or 300 pound, it takes watercolors and acrylics really, really well. All right, let me show you the materials. Well, of course, we're going to Guatemala. And this is the typical loose sketches that I do with the watercolors or acrylics and also the colored pencils. You know, it's just fun to be loose. You're not in your studio, so don't try and think you're gonna produce a magnificent masterpiece. This is information gathering is how I look at it. You know, you're not in your comfortable space in your studio, so you gotta be a little more forgiving in all the materials that you bring. So I love doing this kind of work. This is the Derwent watercolor pencil, and then you hit it with a little bit of water and it turns into a very permanent watercolor. I love this because it's lightweight. Let me show you the other materials that I use. Well, here we are, we have the acrylic. These are the Holbein acrylics. I like them because they're full of pigment, you know, and when you water them down, they don't break apart. They actually act like a watercolor sometimes. And since we're going to be going to Guatemala, I'm taking a set of my fluorescent paints. You know all the wonderful fabrics that they have down there. So I'm going to take a kit of fluorescent acrylic paints from Holbein, heavy body, just great. And for those of you who just want to bring your watercolors, great! I have my little watercolor kits right here. They don't take up a whole lot of space. As you can see, I use them well. But when I do a watercolor, you know, after a while, I don't know what colors these are. So I make my own little chart and keep it there so I know that that's that yellow and this is this black and that's that green. So it's a good thing to have nearby when you're painting. My colored pencils, these are Holbein artist colored pencils. They're great for sketching too. My absolute favorite, of course, are the Derwents. These are the InkTense. You've seen me use these all the time. They come in as a pencil, which are wonderful. And also these big blocks, they look like they're pastels, but they're not pastels. Just be careful them when you should get a box of each. You know, but they are called InkTense, and you can get a nice kit for about 24 of these colors, and it's made by Derwent, and they're permanent. That's what I like about them, really strong colors. Don't forget, you need a water bucket, and I have to like this collapsible water bucket, and just throw the water away at the end of the day, and it packs right into your suitcase again. Don't forget, I take some paper towels. You can probably purchase them on location too in some of the cities we will be visiting. Also, I also put a skin safer, which is basically a concentrated barrier cream in my hands just because, all right? I like to bring some tapes, either some white tape or this brown box tape. It's really sticky. And besides all the colors and all this preparation, oh, I'm gonna show you this too. Forgot to show you my brushes. The brushes basically are, some are watercolor and some are for acrylic paints. The watercolor brushes, of course, are a little more refined, really nice, perfect for this kind of work. And the acrylic brushes, the acrylic paint brushes, a little stiffer, they push the paint around. I like them a lot. I also bring my sketching pencils. My sketching pencils happen to be these the Faber-Castells. And these are artist pit pens. They're wonderful. They come in different thicknesses, fine, medium, and bold. I also will bring even pencils, just regular pencils. I also like to bring these Sharpies. Now remember, Sharpies are nice and black felt. They actually come now oil-based, so they are permanent. If you want to just sketch with an oil-based Sharpie, they're pretty nice too. If you bring these kinds of Sharpies, just know that they're not permanent. Just want you to see the difference. It says oil-based right here. Lots of pencils, sketching pencils. Don't forget a Sharpie knife. Now don't pack this in your carry-ons. You know that. So nothing sharp in your carry-on. What else do I want to show you? Don't forget, wear a hat. Big brother, we don't look pretty, but wear a hat for all the reasons. And don't forget your sunscreen too. Pretty simple arrangement. That way I don't have to pack a lot of stuff and unpack and pack again at the end of the day when we're on location. Keep it simple. It all goes into one side of my suitcase. The other side, I jam in as much clothing as I can. But if you can take two suitcases, make sure one's smaller. And you can put it all in a backpack if you want, if you have a nice size backpack. One of the nice things about going to Guatemala, just to let you know, is they carry all your equipment for you. And they deliver it to our location. So you don't have to worry about that, too. That's what I wanted to show you. Real simple setup and materials. Don't bring everything and a lot of it. So let me show you what I use on location. Remember, I keep it simple. All right, really simple, because you gotta pack it all up again, right, when you leave. So here's my paper. This is my Kilimanjaro paper, 300 pound paper. Here are my Derwent blocks. Again, they look like pastels, but they are not. Here's a whole box of the Derwent InkTense. It's a great word for them because they are intense. So I've chosen some of the pencils here. I have my bag of water over here, collapsible bag. Don't forget a pencil sharpener of some sort. You're gonna need that on location. And here's my brush. So pretty simple, we'll just do a little. I wanna show you how this works. So I put it on dry. And I just sketch. And I'm gonna make sure this. There's some clouds, maybe. Dark up in here. Gets closer, gets lighter. Here's some yellow in here. Now when I mix the yellow and blue, you know what color's gonna come out of that. Yeah, green. I'm just doing this quickly here so you get an idea. Maybe some really hot stuff in here. Here we go. There's some crazy green. Why not? Let's put some green in the clouds. Why not? Some more blue up in here. So again, quick sketches. Didn't need a whole lot of materials. If I wanted to, I can, at this point, use these blocks. Now the blocks really do look like pastels. They almost act like it. But watch what happens when I go to put some water in here. So it's almost like a miracle. All right. There we go. Back over here. Now the best part, the water. Here we go. Look at that color. Do you believe it? And it bleeds just like a real watercolor. Oh, these are nice. Nice paper too, by the way. With the paper towel, you can come in and start wiping away a little bit. There we go. If you want to, you can even bring in some white on top of this. But these are the simple things I just wanted to show you. I can't stop drawing, I just love doing all this stuff. Because there are so many surprises when you work this way. this even darker. Fun little sketch. Didn't spend a whole lot of time on it. I'll turn the page and do another one. Over and over and over. We're gonna be this loose in my kind of workshop that are on location. So this one happens to be a quick little landscape at the beach. And you can use all the watercolor techniques you want, and also acrylics. I could have done this with acrylics, but I wanted to specifically show you the Derwent InkTense blocks and colored pencils. Well, that's pretty simple. Keep it simple, all right? Don't forget to get a hat and some sunscreen wherever we go. And thanks again for watching this, and I hope this helps you and answers an awful lot of your questions about how do you pack for traveling. Take care. I'll see you on the next BobBlast. Hi there, this is Bob Burridge, and I have some great news to tell you. Hey, we're going to Guatemala, and we want you to join us. It's pretty easy. It's wonderful. I've done this before, and thank goodness I'm going back again. I just can't wait to do it. Think about the culture, the Mayan culture, the sculptures, the buildings, the peoples, their colors, their food. The haciendas, we are staying in great places, by the way, down there. And the people and the culture is all around us. I just remember being in one of the big open squares and my entire class was painting. And I looked up and it was the entire school let out just to surround us. The love and the companionship and certainly the colors. It was so inspirational. So I just wanted to invite you there again to sign up now, because you don't want to miss this opportunity. I cannot wait to get back there again. So go to my website, robertburridge.com. I'll see you in Guatemala.